So, hello and welcome to this short version doc webinar for PCS 7. I'm getting a lot of emails and questions and calls asking details about PCS 7, how it looks like, the smart compare, how we support PCS 7, in which details. And therefore, I thought it's maybe a good idea, instead of writing a lot of emails, just to record in 5 minutes a short video to demonstrate the main features in our PCS 7 support. Let me start here by introducing the company. AURESI is the short form for Automated Versioning System. We are the market leader in change management and concentrating here, especially for Siemens devices, in developing smart compares for S7, for WinCC, for PCS7, for TIA Portal, and all the devices which Siemens is offering. If you visit our website, versiondoc.com, there you can find more information. Yeah, if you go here to industries, especially for the to the pharmaceutical industry, there you will find information about audit trail, about regulated industry, and how we fulfill these norms. Besides, if you go to VersionDoc and the customers here, let me check here references under AURESI, then you can also sort here in the different branches. In our case here, you go to the pharmaceutical. There you can see also who already is using VersionDoc in combination with, for example, VersionDoc PCS7. Yeah? There are also some companies like GlaxoSmithKline, like Roche Diagnostic, BioMarin. These are companies who also visited already VersionDoc AURESI, who did audit trails here in-house, analyzed that everything is running in line with FDA GAMP, also our own internal development system, the bug tracking system, all that stuff was audited and is everything in line now with the requirements of FDA and GXP. Yeah, we are also listed here in the top 100 index of IoT. So the IoT itself, IoT1, they analyzed past year 1,600 companies. They looked who is doing development researches for IoT, for Industry 4.0. And I'm proud to say that AURESI made rank 67 in the top 100. So you see here, it starts with IBM, SAP, Cisco, the large ones. But if you scroll down to place 67, you will find AURESI here in Germany. We are quite proud of that, and we still invest a lot in Industry 4.0 research, in development for IoT, also for cybersecurity, and so on. If you type into Google, for example, PCS7 and VersionDoc, you will find us on the Siemens Mall here listed as VersionDoc Data Management, listed here in that case as Symantec PCS7 add-on, where we offer a lot of functionalities, which I will demonstrate now here also later on. Then also, I don't want to miss, if you go to VersionDoc Tutorials, it is under myversiondoc.com. There you will also find the VersionDoc roadmap, if you want to. There you can see what we develop here in the next time. TIA Portal upload will be optimized. The compare will be independent from TIA Portal and so on. So you can see here details in the roadmap, as well as you can find there overview about the devices which we support, about information about smart compares and so on. Good, let me switch here to a VMware image which I have prepared so that I can show you also the PCS 7 support of VersionDoc. Here, first of all, you can see all 4 standard VersionDoc clients. We have an easy client, we have a normal user client, we have a client to create your own reports, as well as you have a client to administer the VersionDoc server. So you don't need to go physically to the VersionDoc server. All clients are free of installation. All clients are free of license. So you can really hand it out to suppliers, to contractors. You can install it on engineering systems as often as you want. We license only the server. And there is one exception for a PCS7 module, which we offer, where we have a client-only solution for engineering stations, where you don't need a server, or where you don't want to have a server at least. Therefore, we have a station only license so that you can work on the engineering station only. But I will inform later on about details about that as well. So how does it work? You double click here on the normal user client, you type in your name, and then you can type in your password. Both can be synchronized with the domain, with the Active Directory, so you don't need to administer the users here inside version doc system. Here you can see the server to which I'm connecting to. In my case, it's called the version of demo server. And when I log in, then it's clear what I'm allowed to see. I have here one project, or let's say four projects, it's a PCSM Muli project, where I have user rights on. If I would have more user rights, I would see more projects, which may be there on the server as well. But in my case, I am only allowed to see here that multi-project of PCS7. So if you, as soon as you click here on a project, then you see on the server are four versions. Locally here on my client is nothing available. So the first thing I need to do is to check out. And there are four versions on the server available. There you see here day and time, who did the last change, the change request, and what he especially changed. And you see here then all the detailed changes which he did. Yeah, if you want to work locally, the first thing would be to check out that project. It starts here with the checkout button. But you could also check out the whole folder here without mouse click. That's also working. Then you see I have already selected all the projects. I can check out only the newest versions. I could also check out the whole history. I can hand it out over to suppliers if I want to. I can take it in development or log it. Development would mean the parallel work at the same time on the same project for me and my team members. But if I want to work exclusively, I would log it and maybe leave a comment to explain how long I will work on that, for example. But let me just take a copy here. Let's check it out and close. So after checkout, the whole projects are locally here on my engineering station available. And a lot of customers are asking, do I really need a server? If I don't want one, is it possible to work with VersionDoc and PCS7 without a server? The answer is yes, of course. We have that quite often, especially for customers who have just an engineering station or two or three, but no server. So no network to a server, and that is possible. So let me show you how that looks like. You close here the client again. You go then locally to the client. You don't log to a server anymore. You keep it locally, the client working. Now we are independent from any server connection. And I need, of course, type in here password, that is right. And then you see the check in, check out button is grayed out. That indicates that I'm now working locally. And that could be here the normal engineering station where the project is located. So in VersionDoc, standard location for projects is here under the VersionDoc client archive. And the next questions customers asking me, is it possible to keep the project somewhere so that they don't have the need to copy to the VersionDoc client archive? The answer is again yes, because if you want to, with a right mouse click, you can edit here the component configuration. And instead of looking to the VersionDoc client archive, you could go there with these buttons and browse out to a project which is somewhere on Engineering Station 1, for example. Engineering Station 2 and 3 do not have that project. It's only on Engineering Station 1. In that case, the Engineering Station 2 and 3, which also contains a VersionDoc client, would then have the need to look here on the central project on Engineering Station 1. That's easy to configure. So you can configure here the working directory, it's somewhere else, and then you just need to arrange here the right archive and path, and then it's working. So you don't need to work in the VersionDoc client archive, the project can also be somewhere else. Okay, let's start here with the project. I have now here locally the possibility to modify something. Here is an editor button. If I click on that, then the project will be handed over to the PCS7 or to the Symatic Manager. That's just a help, by the way. I could also do that manually by going to Start, Program, Symatic Manager, and open it manually. That's also possible, so it's up to you how you would like to work with. So let me open here some examples. Let's go here to let's switch first to the plan view, and then I have here some examples. So here are some SFC and CFCs. Let's go here to the first one. Let's do here some modifications. For example, if I don't need that connection here, I want to delete it, then I can go there, mark it, and say delete. I need to delete here in the connection. Here it is. Then it's gone. Then maybe also here a value. Instead of 30, I want to have 15.0. Okay. And maybe here in the object properties, maybe let's say here in IO, whatever. I go there and say this should be not visible. Okay. So I made three changes. I did not write down what I did. I close here without compiling. I close here just my CFC. Let me go here to SFC as well. Let me see here also such an example. Let's say this and this step here is not needed anymore. So let's delete this. Yes, and close. Maybe product change, I don't need these two steps anymore. Let's close everything. So, and now you see here is already a viewable append. That means the project is changed. Here you see the timestamp when it was changed. It's not in line with the validated version 4. That's the current official version in the version history. So I made changes here, and now it's interesting to see, what is changed? I want to create a new version 5 and document these changes. So the next step is here to create a new version. You click on that button, and then the client compares the version 4 in the history against the modified project here in the working folder. And then you see here already a report window. You can increase that here, so that is a little better to see. And here on the left side, there is the project tree. So you see only these areas where modifications have been detected. And here's the whole chart. So if you want to, it's a large chart. I extra took that example. Then you can, of course, zoom in and see what is there different. And then you will see here, there is already a red line. But if it's a large chart, then it gets quite difficult to find everything. And for that, we have created a nice functionality. So here you see the red line, here you see the 30. So these kind of changes are highlighted. But you see here also a button which says show only differences. If you click on that, then the whole chart is reduced only to these blocks where really changes have been made. So it's much easier to see now what is in detail different. You see here the 15, which I modified from 30, and you see here the red line for the difference of the red line in the connection which I deleted. So you can directly see what is there, what was changed here. This is not there anymore, it's gone. Good, you can also print out these results. So if you want to bring it on paper, no problem. You create your own report. You see here on the right side the old version 4, here on the left side a new version 5, and also here in that report highlighted in red the differences here. So that is one difference which we detected. Then if you go to the next thing, then you will see here also the properties here again, which are modified, and that I switched here from visible to invisible. And my SFC, you can also see here that I deleted that instruction. If you want to see again the whole SFC here, then you can have a look at everything. This is easier to see, it's not that large, but here's also the possibility to show these differences, as well as you can print out that as well. And you see here it totally what is now different. Okay, that is the way how VersionLog is working. What you still need to do, you should explain what you did. So maybe you type in a change request with a number, and here in the detail command, you should add why you modified now data. Why have you deleted here the step 7? Well, that may be a product change. And then you should write it down. Here you can type in over 1,000 letters. If it's not sufficient, there are more fields available. So nobody had ever the need to type in 2,000 letters for one single change. The next thing here in the chart, for example, there I deleted connection and optimized a value. And maybe here, if you want to switch to invisible. Okay. Yeah, then I can create here locally my version because I'm not connected to a server, so this is still grayed out, but locally I can create a new version. It will be added as version 5 here to the history. You see here a yellow sign that means it, or that indicates that I have not compiled yet. I missed to compile. That's also indicated. If I compile, then it would look like all the other versions here. So you can't do something wrong here, as you can see. I'm still able to compare again with the previous version, or let's say if version 3 was good in quality, I could say, oh, let's set this as compare partner and compare against the current one. That's possible. So you can compare on the fly each version against any other to see the differences. You see, by the way, the blocks in the S7 itself, but that's not that interesting. More interesting is the charts itself. So if you want to see there what is there different, then you can see there the whole chart. And if you want to see what was there directly exactly different, then you see here highlighted in red in view activate show only differences, then you have a quite good overview what is now really happened. And here are all the differences between version 3 and version 5. Great, that was a fast overview. Of course, there are much more features included. Maybe one thing I should highlight. You can use here the free compare if you want to. You could go to PCS7. And with the free compare of PCS7, you can mark single charts and compare them instead of comparing the whole PCS7 multi-project with gigabyte of size. That's not needed. If you want to compare single charts, here with the free compare, you just mark on each side the chart, and then you are able to compare. So I go to technologies. I go here to PCS7. You mark the project you are looking for. You can switch here to logical view. Then you have directly the chart view available, like this. If you want to know if there are differences in that chart, you start to compare, and then you see, these both are equal, for example. And you can mark any other as well and have a direct analyze. So one could be on the USB stick, the other one could be on your engineering station, and you can direct do a project analyze. Good, that's it. That's a fast overview. Hope you like what you have seen. If you have more questions, feel free to contact REC, email us, call us, and we can arrange a web meeting with more details. Maybe also more project-oriented. Thank you very much for your interest. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.